चेतसा सर्वकर्माणि मयि सन्न्यस्य मत्परः बुद्धियोगमुपाश्रित्य मच्चित्त सततं भव।
चेतसा सर्वकर्माणि मयि सन्न्यस्य, मेंटली रिनाउंसिंग ऑल एक्शंस इन मी, having me as the highest, mat paraha, buddhi yoga mupashritya, taking refuge in buddhi yoga or the yoga of discrimination, always focus your mind on me. So, what is he saying here? Mentally renouncing all actions, what does it mean? The body continues to act. Then what renounces? The mind must renounce. So the body continues to act. Dedicated actions focused towards a larger cause, for which you need to understand, what am I working for now? Usually it is myself and my family. That's it. Beyond that, you can't think of anything else. So you say, why should I only work for my family? Why can't I work for all the families maybe in my society? Why can't I work for the community? And at some stage, you must fix the ideal for this country, that somehow or the other, I must work towards getting the country back on its feet, back on the pedestal that it always occupied, which is the spiritual leader of the world. And then humanity, all of humanity. And finally, the highest goal, mat paraha, is me as the highest. So the body continues to act. The goal keeps changing. And you must work for the higher goal with the same fervor, the same energy, the same commitment as you work for yourself. In fact, greater. So what do you give up? You renounce the personal desire to achieve. You renounce your individual ambitions. And you just perform your karyam karma. You shift from desire-driven activity to obligatory duty. So you renounce the desire which comes from the past. You renounce the anxiety for the future fruit. And you are completely and totally dedicated to the present action. This is renunciation. Renunciation is not of action. It is acting in a spirit of renunciation. When are we going to understand this? It is a slight misunderstanding of the word renunciation that has led to generations of Indians being completely disconnected from our own culture. It's about time you understand what he's talking about when he says, Chetasa sarvakarmani mahi sanyasya. So when you fix a higher ideal and work towards that higher ideal, the higher takes precedence over the lower. You give up your lower, limited, personal ambitions in life. That is renunciation. So when you take up the higher, is it really renunciation? No, it's growth. It's growth to a higher state. When a child gives up its fascinations for toys, or rather, when the child grows up into a teenager, it gives up its fascinations for toys. When the teenager grows up into adult pleasures, it gives up the teenage joys. Is this called renunciation or giving up? No, it's moving to higher and higher fascinations, fulfillments, happiness. So the body continues to act in a spirit of dedication. The mind renounces all the kachra. This is renunciation. Then he says, mat paraha, with me as the highest. You know, deliberately he uses the word me, because where do you locate Atman? You say Atman, Brahman, God, where is it? Beyond the furthest galaxy in the world. And you think it's far away. It's not far away. It's within you. Yes, it is true that God pervades the furthest recesses of the universe. But how do you locate God? Within you. So you say, with me as the highest, this shift from extroverted pursuit of happiness to an inward looking vision is what he's talking about. Then, how do you reach this? Buddhi yoga, discrimination. What is this discrimination? You pull yourself back from the world and the mind's fascinations with the world and focus yourself on your goal, the highest goal. The highest goal is self-realization. Until you reach there, or if you can't accommodate the highest goal, at least a relative goal which is beyond you. This is yoga. You discriminate thus. And as you start discriminating, this buddhi yoga is what Shankaracharya called as nitya, anitya, viveka, vichara. Whatever it is that you're seeking in life, ask yourself, is this permanent? Is this going to last? Is this something that I am going to take with me after death? If not, it loses its value. What is the value of something that you get today and you lose tomorrow? Youth is something that everybody loses. Everyone enjoys for a while. Everyone loses. So when you understand that, instead of going around Botoxing yourself, you should develop a permanent youth within yourself, which is a shift in attitude, the spring of optimism and positivity. If you have, even though your body may look aged, your mind will retain its freshness and youth till the last day of your life. Things like this. Constantly you need to think, otherwise, you know, when you lose things, you're riding on temporary things. When they go, you crash. Buddhi yoga, in tune with the divine. Discriminate. The same energy which you are now wasting thinking ill of others and hating somebody else and being jealous of a third person and all these negativities and dissipating your energies, the same energy that you're wasting, pull them back and redirect them towards the positive. What a difference it will make in your life. The next is Machitta Satatam Bhava. The mind ever on me. Today the mind is going all over the place. If you sit down and just tell yourself, I must focus on my own development. I must focus on something positive. Before long, in a few seconds, you'll find your attention goes, if you're sitting in the car and say, idiot rickshaw driver, stupid taxi driver, somebody else is blocked. So your entire journey goes in negative thinking. How quickly the mind goes into negativity. To pull it back is a Herculean task, but if you are able to do that, you achieve the highest. With the mind ever on me. How do you do that? Is the question. Take a look at classical music. A classical musician sings various compositions to different lyrics, set to different tunes or ragas and different beats, but the musician's attention never ever shifts from the one note, sa. If his attention shifts from the sa, then he has to stop singing, or he sings besu. Those of us who are not, see, this is a thing that needs to be cultivated. If you play the tanpura and give it to an untrained person, he'll say, "Arre bapre, this is an obstruction for me. Either you play the tanpura or I'll sing, I can't do both." But a classical musician is one who cannot start singing unless he has that tanpura playing that one consistent note. Similarly, classical living is one in which your thought is anchored to the higher while your body goes around perceiving and acting, while your mind is transacting through feelings and emotions, while your intellect is going through various ideas and ideologies. That one anchorage to the higher never is lost. This is classical living. And anyone who lives like this, lives life stress-free, happy, exhilarated, successful, and grows into a towering personality. So what must you do? Continue living the way you're living. Just think of the higher. Next verse.